Here is how to not take things personally. Do you take things too personally? Has anyone told you to just relax? Or maybe you should just stop overthinking it? Or don't take it personally, life's too short. And they might be a family member or a close friend or a coworker. So you know their intentions are great, but they just don't get it. For anyone who already knows my channel, this video is a little bit coachier, more on the side of compassion than my others. Although my other videos, I like to think, don't make me sound like some sort of war criminal. But I entered the American workforce at 18, and 6 years later, I am still surprised at how much my perspective has changed toward other people. I've had less and less moments every day of feeling attacked, and more of feeling like the people who used to attack me are on the sidelines cheering me on with little pom-poms. I've had people on the phone curse me out and tell me to stop f***ing calling them. I've had people hang up on me. I've had people shut the door on me mid-sentence. So many people have walked away from me in a retail environment that they shopped in literally daily. So you'd think they'd be comfortable enough to talk to a stranger trying to pitch them some sort of fixed cost energy plan. One lady threatened to shoot me if I didn't get off her property. But this video isn't about me. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Sam, and I want to make self-growth normal. If you want to make self-growth normal, because people shouldn't have to look this information up, it should just be mainstream knowledge, then make sure to smash that like button for the YouTube algorithm. The purpose of this video is to remind you that things don't have to be so difficult. And you have the power to not let them weigh you down and drain you of your energy. Life doesn't have to be that hard. And I'm about to give you a few things to remember, maybe write down, and try that will help you to not take things so personally. The first one might be the most significant. Number one, know when to stop reimagining. Someone may say something to you, it's usually some kind of rejection. Maybe it's someone of the opposite sex or the same sex rejecting a date. Maybe it's a customer rejecting a price or a family member rejecting your dinner plans because they already said that they had plans at that point again. And this all feels like a never-ending battle that you're fighting uphill. These things happen. I'm sure that you've experienced at least one of them fairly recently. We all have. I swear that this stuff is so common. Maybe we put each other through these things just to force ourselves to learn from them. Here's how you know that you're taking things personally. You know that you're taking a rejection personally when, after it happens, you start thinking about what could have been if you reacted differently. I could have responded differently and I would have made that sale. I could have responded differently and I would have gotten her number. You think and think about, what if I reacted differently? This is completely normal. And maybe you've heard this before about all sorts of conditional human behavior. This is normal. It's okay. It's normal. This is good because it's normal. Let's be real here. Just because a behavior is normal doesn't mean it's good. However, this is good because you are learning from your mistakes, and the more you do it in more situations, the better. But you need to be conscious of when to stop reimagining those scenarios and reliving them in your mind. It's okay to think about these things, but it's important to know when and sharpen your judgment of when you might be starting to overthink them. All that looking back is messing with your neck, man. What do I mean by be conscious? Well, you need to catch yourself in the act. When you come up with some sort of a response, you little perfectionist, I know some of you out there watching might have that temptation to imagine that perfect comeback and try it on someone else the next time this happens. You have to be conscious about, okay, I came up with this response, now I'm gonna use it the next time I run into this situation. Then you can see how perfect it is, you mad scientist. I'm totally projecting here. But I project with pride, but you do need to catch yourself in the act. Number two, benefit of the doubt. It might be better to give them the benefit of the doubt. You never, never know what someone's going through. Even if they tell you, you may never know what they want for sure. Maybe on a better day, they would have said, okay, let's do this. Maybe it's because the weather's bad. Maybe it's because the weather's nice and they sweat a lot and they're very sweaty people. There are a lot of sweaty people in the world, and you do not have to take that personally because they're so sweaty all the time. Let them be sweaty. You're not that sweaty. Maybe you're not one of those people. On a better day, they would have said, okay, let's do this. If they rejected you or said something mean, it might not have been as harsh. The benefit of assuming, they may just be having a bad day. is that once you get in the habit of doing it, you do get in the habit of not feeling as bad when it happens. Maybe it's not a tool that you need to use every time, because many people are just cranky jerks who take their bitterness out on everyone they meet, and you might run into that from time to time. I learned an interesting technique from the book The Charisma Myth by Olivia Fox Cobain. Say that you are going door to door. Someone shuts the door on you mid-sentence. Ouch. Been there, done that. After they shut the door, close your eyes for like just a second and really try to do this. Vividly imagine. Minutes before they hear the doorbell ring, they get a call from the hospital saying that their whole family died in a car crash. If you really try this, you might feel like a jolt of empathy. And it sounds really, really weird. I mean, it's almost, you're kind of lying to yourself in a sense, but it might just work when nothing else does. A quick personal story about benefit of the doubt. Very long story, short as I can make it. A few weeks ago, we found out my girlfriend was pregnant. One day she was in a lot of pain, so we took her to the ER, and our experience there was terrible. There was one PA there and she was super kind and compassionate. However, we had to wait 3, maybe 4 hours. We got blood work done and everything. The PA told us that my girlfriend had a miscarriage. We're still kind of, you know, grieving this, but the main reason I mentioned this is here's the kicker. She apologized for the wait, and I told her, I understand that you guys have been busy, which I say to a lot of people who take too long to do things. And you know what she said to me? She said, yeah, but that doesn't make it any easier on you guys, and it doesn't change how you feel. I had never heard anyone say anything like this before. Those feelings of rejection or bitterness or whatever it is, they're never gonna 100% go away. And it's important to acknowledge that they're still there, but my point with this video is that if you can just try to manage a few things that will stop them from overtaking you, in my experience, it's worth it. Number 3, the world is like this. Now, there might be someone in your life who just gives you advice often that you never feel like following. This, when I was writing it out, sounded like something they might say. But I've been told this before in a way that made me wanna, how do I put this delicately? Crawl up in a hole and die and never come out? So here it goes. Nothing that might be helpful to learn not to take too seriously, nothing like that is only gonna happen once. It's gonna happen over and over again, and you know, that's life. It's messy, it's annoying, it never seems to be perfect. Something always goes wrong. Sometimes it can be overbearing. It can feel like that weighs you down. And a lot of people, believe it or not, will go through life without finding ways to make it easier on themselves. Finding ways to take the edge off that are actually good for their well-being. A good book about this is one that, if you hate self-help books, you've probably still heard of it, The Subtle Art by Mark Manson. The world is like this. And the more you take those humiliations and rejections and insults and what feels like intangible attacks on your soul or something, the more you can take those in stride and come out the other side better off, the more perspective you'll gain, the more resilience you'll show. You have to earn your trident every day, as they say in the Navy, but it is worth it. If you don't try it, just try it, and once you feel those results, you'll start to see them in every single area of your life. I swear, it is not just my experience talking here. Instead of everything I just said, I've been told, well, that's life. You just gotta suck it up. That's how the world works. If that's how the world works, and I just gotta suck it up, then why are we here? If that's life, then what's the point? Well, that's up to you. It can be whatever you want it to be, and that is the magic of realizing you have an option of a reaction to these things. Number 4, laugh it off. Okay, really? Laugh it off? I'm supposed to laugh these things off? I know, it's way easier said than done. Someone just called me an idiot for not knowing what a debit card is. Someone just hung up the phone on me mid-sentence. I'm just doing my job. I just asked this person on a date and they said no to me. How is that funny, Sam? How can I laugh at that? It makes me feel like I'm not worthy of better things. Don't worry, they're not that important. It's just easier for people to not face what's right in front of them. How are you supposed to laugh it off? Well, this is where imagination comes in handy. This is where it helps to exaggerate their reaction in your mind into something so absurd. Such a big deal that you cannot take it seriously. Someone called you an idiot for knowing what a debit card is?
What's a debit card? Is that some kind of, is that like an Uno card or is it like a Yu-Gi-Oh card? Oh well, I lose. I guess I lost the game.
Someone said no to a date. Apparently she has a boyfriend. Oh, that's okay. I have 8. Laugh it off. Grand, you might be watching these things and you're like, Stan, this isn't even funny. What are you talking about? One guy didn't even let me talk. He was like,
you guys call me 10 times a day and I work the night shift.
I'm never buying a f***ing car from you. Stop f***ing calling me. Well, of course you would never buy a car from us. Obviously, I haven't seen that new Netflix show. One is the new 10. I've just been too busy selling cars to people at 3 a.m. to help this guy out. Don't say these things out loud. You know, put a humorous spin on it. Something else that really helps is imagining them saying those things in a voice that makes them sound completely ridiculous. Imagine Lil Jon saying it,
or Mr. Krabs, or Kevin Malone.
Number 5, the last one, is be too busy to care. I've talked about this before on my channel, and I've talked about it a lot, because you'd be surprised how much throwing your worries into taking care of others and taking care of yourself can turn from worries about what others think to concerns about making things happen. And you'd be surprised. I swear. I've been swearing a lot in this video about how empowering that is. I can't worry about that. I'm too busy to care. Be too selfish. Be too selfless to let those things get to you. You have a life ahead of you. And that life, the older you get, is going to go by faster and faster over time than you think. You'd be surprised how little time we all have. The universe is 13.8 billion years old. It's not getting any younger. The universe is not getting any younger, and it's not going to wait for us to put a dent in it. When you shift your focus from what are they gonna think of me to I gotta get back to work on this project, I have stuff to do, your whole energy can shift away from those negative emotions. And it feels good, but you have to be busy and busy on things that are fun and things that are exciting to you, or at least things you can learn to be excited about. Sometimes I think that hard work saved my life. When I was 17, I went to a psych ward for anxiety and depression 4 times. And back then, I just had way too much free time on my hands to be focused on the good things in life. When I think of the things that made me depressed back then, it all sounds now like some sort of bad dream that doesn't really mean anything anymore. Generation Z, based on what I've heard and based on all the TikToks that my girlfriend has shown me, I just wish that it overall cared more about learning to enjoy meaningful work. Many of us love having fun, and many of us love to work, but where do those two meet? Where is that middle ground? Find it, and I promise you, your life is gonna it's really gonna change. So that's how to take things personally. Is there anything you guys have tried? If there is, please let me know if it's how it's worked out, and if there are any other similar topics you guys want me to talk about on this channel. I'm gonna link in the description links to each book if you wanna check them out and read the reviews that I recommended. If you guys buy anything through those links, then I get commission, which helps me build this channel. Other than that, please make sure to hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't already, because I don't get why people watch this far in my videos and they don't subscribe, but if you have subscribed and you wanna turn it up just a notch and turn on that notification bell to get a notification every time I drop a new video, that would mean the world to me. Sorry, my camera's about to die, that's why I'm talking so fast. Otherwise, thank you guys so much for watching, I really appreciate it. You can find me everywhere and I will see you then.